AOA International Students Relations here at ORU. So I have the pleasure of working with Angela, our recruiters, Lisa, and so we're very excited to do this today. I was actually an international student when I came to ORU. So back in 2015, I started my MBA here. And at that time, finding a job was on my top priority. And it was very difficult doing that. So our goal with this session today is to kind of pave that way for you guys and in any way that we can make that process be a little bit smoother for you. So today you're going to hear from Kaylin Henderson. He's the director over at Career Service, and he's going to share some of the resources we have. They do a lot of individualized work as well. So as you meet with them and tell them what you're looking for, they have amazing tools filtering jobs for internationals. And we also invited some international students who did their CPTs, OPTs, and are now full-time employees with outside companies. So I thought that would be great for you guys to hear from them as well, ask them questions, tips, ask the companies they work for, maybe ask for a job at the end. I don't know. You guys be creative on how you explore this opportunity today. But I'll go ahead and have Kaylin get us started. And then we'll go from there. I'll just open us with Ray and I'll pray for the food as well. Dear Heavenly Father, thank you so much for this day that we've made. Thank you for the opportunity to be at ORU. And God, you just know each one of us so well, God. And for all of the students in the room, you know where they are. You know what they need, God. And so I pray a special blessing over your favor for jobs, God, for the international community. In so many ways, this is a way that blesses them financially to complete education here in the U.S. and it supports them in so many ways. So I pray for open doors, for favors as they're going through this process, God, and that today will be a great informative meeting to help them go in that direction. In Jesus' name I pray. Amen.
All right, so like she said, my name is Callum Henderson. I am the Director of Career Services for ORU. All right, so basically what we do in Career Services, our goal is to essentially help all of our students get a job or an internship, right? So we do that in a number of different ways. We help with instructive services such as building your resume, writing a cover letter or personal statement if you're going to medical school, practicing your interviews. A lot of times we can practice the interviews with our staff, or we can bring external employers to campus. And so just to find out whether or not they want to hire you on the spot, right? So easy way to find out what you can practice in order to kind of enhance that ability to find and get a job. We also help new students figure out what kind of majors we offer, what kind of careers are associated with those majors, is that career increasing or decreasing, and how much you're going to be making after you graduate. And the last thing we do is we pretty much operate this job board, which is called Handshake. And so one of the best ways we know to find a job is to place all these opportunities that we find out about in one place. And so over the last 12 months, we've had over 100,000 jobs and internships listed on this platform. So it is a really easy way for us to kind of make sure that our students know what is available. And so how many of you have been on Handshake before? Okay. So in order to log in, you go to this website, which is called oru.joinhandshake.com. You can download it on the mobile app store, Google Play, but anyways, what it can do is, it essentially, when you first log in for the first time, there's like a brief assessment that you can take that will basically ask you a little bit about yourself, what your major, what kind of career you want to go into, and after that, it's kind of recommending or creating this dashboard about opportunities that really may fit you. So pretty much you can see anything that's kind of catered to what you're looking for. So new job recommended for you, job roles, populated by your major, based on my browsing activity, jobs expiring soon. So it's just kind of an easy way to see at a glance what kind of opportunities present itself. But one of the first things I recommend doing when you first log into Handshake is creating a profile, because what this does, it allows employers to actively see you and send you messages and really kind of target, what kind of opportunities may be best suited for you. So this is kind of my example. You can see a little bit about my history. You can see an education. You can see work and volunteer experience. You can see what other students are doing that may be similar to you. You can highlight skills. You can attach your resume, your documents, things like that. But the whole purpose of this is to essentially get you seen by outside organizations. So let's see if I can see. So, really easy way, and once they kind of view your profile for the first time, you can actually see which employers will message you. Oftentimes, they'll go to this inbox, and so, like, let's say if I look in my inbox, for example, you can see all the employers that have messaged me from my kind of student account, right? So you can see, you know, Forbes, you can see Captain Cruise, you can see PwC, EY, City Year, and all these people are saying, like, hey, you basically want to follow up with you and like your profile, for example, would you be interested in applying for these jobs, right? So if you have an active profile, this is a really easy way to get invited to different types of opportunities, events, and something you may not be just actively aware of, so it always helps for somebody like outside source to be looking for you as well. Of course, the number one thing this platform is used for is going to be the jobs piece. And so for international students, we want to also focus on these filters. So at the very bottom of this, you can actually see OPT, CPT, or will sponsor or does not require a U.S. work visa. So let's say if I click this box and then I hit search, show results, then you can see like there's 4,000 opportunities that you could apply for today that basically would count for OPT, CPT, or they're willing to kind of go that route with you. And you can also do the same thing for sponsorship. So if I go down here again and I click on sponsorship, it would bring up a new list of employers. And you can search for a number. You can actually go by location. I think there's 100 in Tulsa, for example, that you can search for. So if I go click on Tulsa, it show results. And again, this is other internships and different types of opportunity that, again, in Tulsa, that would basically sponsor or provide OPTC. So that's an easy way. We also just now created kind of a curated list. So if I was to click on this Career Center tab, and I go down to Hires International Students, we created a list of a couple of organizations. I think there's about 45 on this list that we know for a fact hire international students. The maximum we can place on this list is about 50. And so it's a really easy way. If you were to follow all these employers, you would be instantly notified anytime they posted a job or an internship. So these organizations are hiring international students, you can follow them, and you're just going to get an email every time they would post a job or an internship. And this would allow you to really easily stay up to date without having to log in every day about what kind of opportunities can be available. And you know that instantly that these organizations would, be applicable and able to hire you. Outside of that, we of course have, our events tab. How many of you went to the career fair? Okay. Those are the people that are in your job, so good for you, right? Good for you, yeah. So, easy way, we had the biggest career fair ever. We had 123 organizations in the Navy Center, and they were all actively hiring. So some of the organizations there had opportunities that were available that they just didn't have the chance to post on Handshake. So some of the students that were able to go there obviously got opportunities that just weren't available to everybody. So one of the easiest ways you can do or find a job is just to attend a career fair. Everybody is recruiting, you know that they're hiring specifically for ORU, and you know all the different roles that they're hiring for. So really easy way to get involved, stay connected, and the number one way to find a job realistically is going to be networking, right? It's all about who you know and how well you know them. So building those relationships each time they're on campus is very important. So if you click on the events tab, it's going to show you all the upcoming events that are on campus. So you see that we're hosting a sports management fair in November. You see there's table recruitings coming up for different companies that will be outside of our office. You can see there's virtual events of PwC. Oftentimes you'll see events from Google or NASA or all sorts of just different really cool organizations that you can just do meet and greets or connect with the outside organizations and firm. And again, this is an easy way to stay connected. And of course, the last tab is this employer piece. So if I click on employers, it's gonna allow me to search by over 600,000 different employers that we have in our system. So you can type in any one of these organizations. I'm just gonna click NASA on this up here, and it'll bring up their homepage. So you can see a little bit about what they do. You can see who the contact information, what the recruiter's email is. You can see all their social media handles. You can see what jobs they have posted currently at ORU, so electronics engineer, entry-level engineer, currently posted at NASA. You can see attachments, and you can see other students who have worked there before. The last thing you can do is you can, of course, read reviews. So what do students like about working for NASA? So So again, if you scroll down a little bit, it will say, you know, what do they like about it? What do they wish was different, and advice that they would give somebody going through this role for the first time? So you can read, again, 100 different reviews from other students who have kind of been in your shoes and have been in these kind of opportunities. You can even follow up and ask them further questions in case you were just curious about, you know, more in-depth, you know, processes. And then, of course, this last piece is going to be the interview tab. So if you click on the interview tab, it's going to allow you to pick something, so we'll just click the password in turn. And it's going to say, what was that interview process like? What was one question that you were asked? So again, interviews can be scary, they can be stressful, mm-hmm. You don't know what kind of questions they will ask a lot of times. And this kind of eases a lot of that fear. So it's like kind of having a cheat sheet for a test, right? So how many would like a cheat sheet for your test, right? So if you're going through this interview and you have, you know, you're reading this and you read everybody posting like these same 20 questions, you know to go in there prepared for these 20 questions, right? So a lot of times it can kind of ease your nerves a little bit. You know what kind of style of interview questions they're going to ask, whether behavioral, for example. And again, it just kind of makes it a little bit more comfortable experience when you're applying, right? So what would that process like? You know, what was one question you were asked? So I recommend, of course, if you follow all these employers, they know hire international students, you know, reading different types of interview questions or reviews from these organizations can be quite helpful. And of course, the last tab is going to be this career center piece. And so, again, like I said, we have curated employers here. We also have a resource tab you can click on. And this will basically show you, you know, an example resume. It'll show you an example cover letter. You know, what exactly is an applicant tracking system? How is that used, right? So again, most organizations are using this, so it's important for us to kind of know how to get past that. And so I would recommend, if I was you in your shoes and you're looking to kind of start this process, swing by our office, let us know who you are, what kind of opportunities you're interested in. A lot of times we can send you jobs while you're looking as well to kind of ease that burden a little bit. We can help you create that resume that's going to be seen by a prospective employer, and again, just make you succeed in that interview. So again, hopefully I look forward to seeing you guys in our office, and if there are any questions. Yes, sir.
Where can we find your office again?
So our office is right next to the coffee shop, really easy to find, LRSB 314. So if you look at the coffee shop, if you're looking straight at it, it's going to be a little light.
Okay.
I wonder what kind of platform is Handshake. Is it mostly
campus-based? So any time that an organization is posted on Handshake, it is specifically posted to ORU, right?
So what's the difference from LinkedIn or Indeed?
Absolutely. So LinkedIn, Monster, Indeed.com, they're going to be external platforms that anybody can post, and really they're posting to the world, right? There's no other criteria other than they're just posting it out there. One thing that Handshake does that is different is it's posted specifically for ORU students, right? So if they're posting, it's going to be just for ORU students that are actually looking at it, right? So anything they see could be different from another college, right? So, but LinkedIn is going to be, or Indeed is going to be something that the whole world can see, for example. Does that make sense? So this is kind of a safe platform. You know that they're specifically targeting college students, and Indeed may not, right? So it just may be open to the world. And so, again, you know what you're kind of getting when you go on Handshake. Yeah. And you're welcome to use any platform to find a job, right? This is just another resource. Yeah. Any other questions? Perfect. Well, thank you again for your time. If you have any questions, again, I look forward to seeing you guys.
Work off campus as long as you're related to your degree, okay? So if you're a brand new student this semester, you're not eligible for it until you complete two semesters. If you're a grad student, you can do it, you're eligible right away, so you don't have to wait the two semesters, okay? So we do have the paperwork in our office, so basically if you find a job off campus that would relate to your degree, you have to get them to sign a paper, you have to take it to your academic advisor, your advisor has to say how it relates to your degree, and then we can issue a work authorization that goes on your I-20. Okay, so part-time is typically what we do, it's 20 hours or less. Full-time is available, and that's more for like probably in the summers, and so you don't have school. So that's CPT. OPT is optional practical training, and that's for after you graduate. Like Liz, he's going to come up and talk to in a second, but basically you're going to apply for a work authorization card for 1 year after you graduate. You still have to work in your field. OPT does cost $410, so just kind of keep that in mind when you're graduating. Your last semester is when you apply for that. We'll help you with all of it, but it does cost $410. Now the CPT, what I just talked about, is free. There's no cost for you. So does anybody have any questions for that? No? We have all the information in our office. If you have more questions, please continue.
Yeah, so 3.5. In the GC building, that's where Lisa's at. So if you guys have any questions about CPT, you can go and ask. There is a package that we fill out. It's very easy, but mostly it's just really important that you guys start thinking about those things. Those are really good ways for you to train in your profession. So it's experience beyond the classroom. And it's a great experience for your resume, for, you know, when you go back to your country, having the opportunity to have worked in the United States and get your education is something really good. And for me, it's really important that you guys know that there is a way. We have had a lot of international students do CPT. This is a practice that has been happening. I did mine when I was studying here. Actually, I was still doing it not too long ago. So this is something that it's tangible. This is something for you guys. So we want to help you get there. And so today we also invited a few of our international students. So I invite them to come up here. They have done it. And so I would love for them to share a little bit about their experience. So how was it? How did you find your employment for OPT or CPT? How did you go about going after the company? How was the process? Because here's the thing. A lot of companies, they're a little bit ignorant. When it comes to internationals, they can get a little scared because they think, oh, they're going to require the a work visa, and that's going to be so much money. So my office, and I am very happy if you guys have an opportunity, and if the company needs more information, we'll inform them. We'll help clarify to them, no, you do not have to give them a visa. They can do CPT. They can do OPT for a year. So there's a lot of it that we're still, you know, teaching people that they don't know. But it's important that we work together on that so you guys can have the experience at ORU that you were aiming for. So I will give the mic to, okay, so Ruth will go first. She'll introduce herself and talk a little bit about her experience.
All right, my name is Ruth. I came to the US about 8 years ago, 7. I started at PBC. I don't know if, well, it's not PBC anymore, it's BC. Victory Christian College, I believe, Victory College. And I started in ministry, and I started my CPT actually at Victory, working for the kids care department at Victory. And because it's considered in-campus work, on-campus work, I got CPT. It was pretty easy, the process to get the job, not as easy, but the process, once I got the job, the process to get your social security number, all of that, it was really easy. Once I graduated BBC, I got my OPT from BBC, and the OPT, you get to work for a year on the field that you graduated, and that's when I actually got the job. Like, that's when I moved to Dr. Presley and Associates. That's where I work today. I'm a general manager. about my work is there's a mix of everything that I've studied for. So I could transition from that to my master's when I got to transfer to ORU, because my work, there's ministry, business, and counseling, and there's so much that you can learn from Dr. Presley and Associates. There's so many fields that you can learn working there. And I started in ministry and in one of the offices. That's why I was able to do a lot of missions trip. They do a lot of local missions. It's a doctor's office. It's an optometrist's office, which is like your eye doctor, your regular eye doctor. And it was since I had the OPT, it was pretty easy to transition from on campus to Dr. Presley, since I already had that document. And then once I transferred to ORU, I had to, when my OPT expired, I got to get my CPT with Lisa. It was a very simple process. At the time, I was working at the offices a lot more, and I was able to. So what I did, because you actually have to get a job description of what you do to prove to Lisa and the people at your of your major, the dean and
the chair,
yeah, that what you're doing actually relates to what you're studying. So what I did is I got a description from the classes that I was taking. And I went to my manager at the time, and I sat down with her, and I was like, can you write me a job description where you can find the things on this description for the classes where it applies here? And she did that for me. So she wrote a job description. She was able to find all the things from the classes that I was taking that was actually that applied to the offices, and then she wrote that job description. I took it to Lisa. I took it to a lot of other people in the office as well. I was like, "Do you agree with this job description? Is this what I'm doing? Am I growing here? Like, based on what I'm studying, am I going to grow on this area? Is working here?" And they all agreed. So I took it to Lisa. And actually, I took it to the chair of my department. They read the job description, and they were able to authorize that for me. And then I took it to Lisa. Lisa approved my OPT, my CPT. I worked with a lot of acronyms. And from then on, it was pretty easy. You just have to make sure that you're renewing that every 6 months or every school period. Make sure you're going through that process again, going to the people at your job, making sure you have those signatures, going to the chair here at your department or your major department, and getting those signatures, and then you go to Lisa. And it was pretty simple. And after that, as I kept growing in the company and getting other positions, I would do the same thing. I would sit with my superior with the description of the classes that I was taking, and I was like, what are the things from those classes that I'm applying here? And then she would write a job description, and I would just go back and forth. That's pretty much what I did. And,
yeah. Awesome. Thanks for sharing. And if you stay here as well, then I'd love for you guys, if you have any questions that they can answer. And I was at the V as well. The V was one of our, you can stay up here. The V was an undergrad engineering, and he also found a job, he found a CPT, and then still full-time in the same company. So after Schlitz shares, I'll have the V share as well about his experience finding the job and how that went on.
Hello, how are we doing today? Love to hear it. So this is the exciting news. I know, like, all of us decided to come to school here in the States for this very moment, you know, look at what we can do with creating our career and, you know, taking the big step to actually becoming adults. It's cliche, but it's adults. But with that said, so I graduated last year in April, and now I work for a company called this year in April. Wow, that's crazy. I feel old. It's felt like a year, okay? I'm already getting gray hairs. This has been a long year. But I work for a company called Labor, and I am the marketing coordinator for them. I started off as a recruiting coordinator, and I've been blessed enough to be promoted twice in that company. A lot of it is a lot of the gifts and the talents and the lessons that I got here through leadership, through classes, through coming to events like this and getting the chance to speak like this, through people like them pouring into us. So I was blessed enough to have that opportunity. But with that said, in terms of OPT, CPT, and big paperwork and everything, for me, it was a pretty straightforward process. Go talk to your international student coordinator. They will tell you what you need. Go talk to Lisa. And Lisa's sweet, guys. She's so sweet. She was up here for like 30 seconds, but y'all didn't understand. She's one of the sweetest people on this campus. She's here for you guys. These are people that are here to help you guys and use the resources that they have to provide for you guys. So if you guys have questions, go ask. They're fine. They'll answer all of them, even if they're dumb. Trust me. I have plenty of them. But yeah, so for me, it was just, I started looking for a job straight out of like about November-ish, and I had my resume ready, I had my cover letter ready, which, by the way, work with your professors on, work with the career services. Kevin read my resume at least 15 times, and I was literally like refining everything about it, so make sure you're getting that ready and have your cover letter ready. That way you already know and you already have it revised, that when you go to an interview, you're like, yeah, I know everything that I'm talking about, I didn't just come up with this last week. So then you go, through the process, you apply for jobs, apply for anything that you can, apply for anything that really has to do with what you want to do. And like, I know all of us have dreams, and like, my dream was to be a CEO, but I can't go apply to be a CEO, that doesn't make no sense. So I had to look at like what's realistic. I had to pray about it and ask God, like, okay, where is it that you want to put me? Where is it that I should go? What's the right step for me? And you apply to the jobs that you feel led to, you apply to the jobs that make sense for you. And the interview process, a big part of it is just really knowing yourself and really knowing what you stand for and what your core values are. And a big thing I would encourage you guys being international students is take advantage of the fact that the majority of us are bilingual. Most of like these companies are like, oh wow, they speak more than one language. They can reach to more than one group of people. These people will bring diversity into our company. And that's just a great way to start a conversation. And for them, you come in there and you're confident, like, hey, I speak more than one language. I will bring value to your company. I'm not just another guy that's gonna come in and do all the basic cookie cutter stuff, but I'm gonna bring diversity. I'm gonna bring an international worldview. I'm gonna bring in the idea of the fact that I've lived in more than one place, and I've been through so many different experiences and so many different cultures. And that adds value to you as a student and as an individual. So you go through the process, let's say you get a job, that's when the OPT process starts. One thing that I will say is for those of you that are seniors in here, make sure that you have money saved up, because you will avoid that your parents are prepared, because OPT costs money, your apartment costs money. Guys, like, apartment isn't just your first month of rent. There's this like leasing rent, there's insurance, there's so many things that I was like, oh! Like, they told me pay this. I said, but that's in my rent. No, they're like, no, this is different. I'm like, no. I don't have money for that. But yeah, like, you just gotta have your money saved up, and you gotta be prepared for some of these expenses, because being an international student isn't cookie cutter typical process. I hate to say this, but we're not Americans, and we don't have the privilege of just like, yeah, I'm gonna go apply and da 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 da. But you need to be aware of what's coming and be fully prepared and have all the things ready. Have your finances ready, have your resume ready, have your cover letter ready. Start looking at, like, if you get a job, start looking at apartments around there. How much are they gonna cost? Will your salary go with it? What type of lifestyle do you have to live? Will you need a car? I know for me, it was like, I had this job, I had my OPT, I had everything figured out, but it was like, I don't have a car yet, so where am I gonna live? I need to live close to my job. So that's what I needed to do. But yeah, definitely mention it in your interview. Be like, hey, I'm gonna be working on OPT, which allows me to work for you for a year. Like, because a lot of them, like she said, they don't know. So if you really let them know, like, hey, I have OPT, I'm allowed to work for you for a year, but after that, I will either need sponsorship or this path, and you show that you know what you're talking about, but like, hey, I will need sponsorship, or I'll need to go back to school and do CPT, and you can negotiate that, or you can tell them, like, hey, I can only work here for a year if you guys are not willing to sponsor me. That way you're putting it out there and you're offering them solutions. A big thing in the real business world is like, if you're gonna present a problem, offer a solution. Don't just be like, I can only work here for a year. Then they're like, okay. But if you're like, okay, I can work here for a year, but after that, these are the avenues that I can take if you guys want to continue with me, then they'll be like, okay, like they actually want to stay here for a long time. They show initiative, their future planning. There's so many different things in there. Trust me, I did recruiting for a little bit. Hearing that means a lot to an employer. But yeah, other than that, I would say definitely use your resources, jump into them, ask them questions, and yeah, thank y'all.
I don't have much to say after that.
that was really good. Thank you. Well, my name is David. I came here to ORU as a transfer student in 2018. And in 2018, as an engineering student, the entire like transfer department helped me a bunch. Because I was dropped here by God in a parachute, honestly. I came and visited here once in December, and 3 weeks later I was here studying. So it was a little bit hard for me. I met a lot of friends, Jess, who I entered the Brazilian group here as well. But I came here with a goal that was to do like study and to do networking. That was like the main goal, because I came from Brazil with already electrical engineering degree. I already had a degree, but my degree here in the US was not recognized. So I had to go through the entire thing again. And then companies here would just not hire me because they just didn't know what was my school in Brazil, what I did. So I had to go through all again. So I came to ORU, the entire department started working with me to bring all my, most of the classes that they could. And then I got a really good, almost from the 4 years that you have to do, like a two and a half years. They basically took out. So basically, I came here, right? I'm already almost a junior. I don't have much time, so I need to work on trying to find an internship right away. So I started asking people. I didn't know. So when you don't know, just ask. Don't wait for just God to show you the way, because He will show you the way whenever you ask to someone. So I started asking people, hey, is there an internship? I went to the engineering department. Hey, is there any companies looking for internships? Start asking people that I know, starting applying on LinkedIn and went into Google, companies that are like internship and apply, just apply. I received a bunch of those. I forgot how many those. And as I started to know people here, professors started to tell me, hey, there's an opening for a summer job. Do you want it? Yes. And then I would apply, and then a no. It was even in the company that I applied, and then the company saw that I was international. And because the company never worked with international students, the company said, no, I don't want to go through the entire visa process. Exactly because what he said, the company didn't know that there is a CPT program that you can work, that is totally legal, that it is cheaper than doing visa, and it is only for a certain period of time. But because the company didn't know, the company basically denied, internship for me. But I started looking for, and then I found one guy that was recommended by the secretary of the engineering department. And then she emailed the guy and said, hey, can I share your email with this ORU student? Because this guy was also a ORU alumnus. And the guy said, yes. So I emailed him. Hey, my name is David. I'm on an engineering program. Here's my resume. I'm looking for a summer internship opportunity. I can do CPT. I already kind of gave as much as much information I could there. And they go, yeah, sure, hey, like a, oh, we made it back, like a silence for 2 months. 1 week before his cruise ended, I was, God, he told me to come, I heard that. So I went by faith. And I'm here, I don't have an internship, it is already summer, I don't want to go back to Brazil to spend, like, to do nothing in Brazil. And I wanted to be here doing nothing because it's really expensive to be here doing nothing. It was 10 p.m. inside of the library. I knew the guy again. Hey, do you have any response? It is almost like summer. I'm still looking at the guy on the next day. Yes, there he is. Can you come here next week? The guy basically forgot because the guy is busy. But you have to keep in touch. Keep pressing, be always polite, but keep asking, keep knocking on the door, so people will remember you. Next week I went there, went for an interview, 5 minutes, and they got, yeah, sure, I have an internship for you, can you start in 3 weeks? Great. I during this time I was working with Lisa to get all the CPT worked out. And everything, the company gave all the paperwork. It's fine. I did some.
Talk to me. He's like, look, those are the people that we're considering for this management position. We really like you. We wish you would be the manager, but you are an international student. Do you know, like, what would be the ways? We know a few things, but what would be the ways for us to be able to get you to this position? And I actually, because I knew, I only knew about the 83, but there were other options like work visas and stuff. But I was able to give them the options of what routes they could choose, and they ended up talking to an immigration lawyer. But because I was able to tell them that there were ways that they could do that, they offered me a position.
All right, so questions for them? No questions? All right, thank you guys so much. I think what you guys heard here is a lot of, you guys are pioneers, right? You left your country, you came to a whole new country to study. Nothing is really easy for international students, but there is a way. People have walked the way before you. There's so many resources through career service, through our office. There is a way, it is possible. Do not give up and pursue your dreams. If you do want an internship, make sure that you're out there making plans. I love what David said. Present them to the Lord and know that you have a whole team here cheering you on. So thank you guys so much for coming. We still have a little bit more food back there. And if you feel free to connect with any of them or to ask these questions or with my staff. Thank you guys. Have a great day.